before he got there. There's a nine.
Well, we go back and we'll take a look at Jordan and say, I got to put some pressure on. And, you know, again, you can't ever tell what he's going to do. He looked like he might have done a 360 or something, turned inside out, and kicks his legs out, and the crowd responds.
And only a 47. The crowd not real happy with that. I tell you what, I couldn't do that one in my dreams. Michael Jordan said that he hoped to get to the finals with a dunk that was not as spectacular as the one he wanted to pull out then. So he did get a 47. He is now the leader, number two out of the five who have dunked so far. 41. So 41's the number here that Dominique needs to better in order to advance to the semifinal rounds. Dominique Wilkins from the Atlanta Hawks, the 1985 champion, 6'7", 200 pounds. Well, that'll draw a high score, I tell you that right now. Now, we saw a reverse two-hander before, Steve, early in the competition, but not with the flair that Dominique just put on that, or with the power.
And the quickness. He exploded into that basket right down there. You take a look. Now, watch out. I think what he does is really give it some juice. He cradles the ball, then spreads his legs out and really throws it down. That's a good pop from Oakley.
A 49 for Dominique Wilkins to put him in first place. So it's Wilkins with 49, Jordan 47, Drexler 44, Anderson 42. Dominique Wilkins, he first dunked when he was a 5'8", ninth grader. Here comes Michael Jordan. Jordan had a 47 on his first dunk. Needs 41 points on this to be first in this first round. He'll get more than 41.
Now, see, again, that was very similar to the Dominique dunk. But again, the legs are out. He double clutches the ball. I mean, things that catch the eye of the judges. Watch it again. Here he takes off. Now watch, the legs are out in the air. He pulls them up. He spreads them out. Pulls it from down low, up high for the two-hand dunk. That's an appealing dunk.
And kind of leans his head out of the way to give the illusion, I'm really up there. Watch, he look it, and he gets his head out of the way and throws it over the top.
And the crowd has booed the 47 that Jordan was awarded. He has two 47s for 94 points. Remember, there are seven competitors. Ron Harper had to drop out today because of a foot in number to beat is 79 for Wilkins to advance.
Oh, now that's a 360 with just a little authority, folks.
So effortlessly, Steve.
That's what I was going to say. He does it so easy, you know, he just kind of walks his way in and then suddenly...
Chicago Stadium, the Slam Dunk Championship semifinals now will be Dominique Wilkins, Michael Jordan, Clyde Drexler, and Otis Smith from the Warriors. Now, in this round, three dunks for each competitor.
Well, Jordan got out of the gate last time with something special, and he wants to do the same as we start this round.
Uh-oh. Measuring off the free throw line. Jordan once said he thinks the perfect dunk would be a 360 from the free throw line.
Okay, with two minus 10 and counting to liftoff.
Oh, they're on their feet at the stadium already. This is reminiscent of the ABA Dunking Championship and Julius Erving many years ago.
Mission Control ready for launch.
That brought Dominique to his feet. Jordan says he likes to dribble the ball when he does a dunk, as opposed to just running with it, because he thinks that's really part of the rhythm and part of the game, and he should do that. For Michael Jordan on his first dunk of the semifinal round.
Well, Jordan just taking his time, and it appears, and I think this is what helps him. He accelerates right at the end, just misses behind the line, but still, that's tough to beat.
You see him coming at you. Dribbling. The tongue out, a flare with the legs and the palm, and throw it through.
Very nice, Michael. Little clutch with the right arm as he goes down the first 50 that's been awarded today. And next comes Otis Smith, the 6'5 guard forward from Golden State.
All-Star Saturday, along with Rick Barry, Steve Jones, this is Bob Neal.
He wasn't no joke.
He didn't go anywhere but from 15 feet in, but it seemed to be just as impressive again because he brought it down real low and then just powered it home.
He has so much power. Now just look at this explosiveness as he takes off right in front of him, a complete 360 rear dealer through
Two different dunkers, man. You can't compare that. Mission control. Bang.
It's nothing new, but again, it's spectacular and in front of the whole crowd. Well, that's what I call the Chinese Superman dunk, because he kind of flies a little sideways there, got a little slant to the shot. There he goes. Now he leans in, fires it through with the extension of the arm, and he only got a 48, so obviously the judges are pretty tough this year. They're tough and relatively consistent thus far. Compared to his 50, that might be a 48. That sounds pretty good.
Well, when you look at it again, and this is the one that got everybody juiced up a year ago, it looks just as good. It looks like a 50 to me.
It sure does, Steve. That's the one he calls the kiss the rim, because it takes his face right up to the rim, ducks under, then windmills. He said, previous to this, that he was going to add a twist to that dunk for the competition today. Let's see if he advances. He was disappointed, and the judge has given him a 49 in his first dunk.
A real good view of just how tough and powerful Dominique Wilkins is.
47. Oh, he got a 47. He's not going to be happy with that score. 49 in the first, 47 on this one. That's, I don't know, I disagree.
Well, now I'll tell you, see, he put a little flair after he put the dunk through, but when he went up, he makes the spin move, goes up nice and straight, held on his hair, didn't do anything spectacular with the arms. He didn't put as much flair as he normally does into his dunk, Steve, so I would think that score was more indicative of what he had performed as opposed to the last one, which he deserved a 50 on.
Well,
so
that's going to put him into the championship round with Jordan.
One more dunk. Well, he's got to make sure he just makes the next one. I think the other competitors have basically almost eliminated themselves. Unless now Nate were to miss two of them, he should go in. Same with Michael. Jordan has 98 points. Wilkins, 96. Drexler, 87. Smith, 67. Virtually eliminated. He must make the dunk. Otherwise, the maximum he gets is 25, and that could be costly. That could make the situation resulting in one of the other players to sneak past him.
Oh, no. What's he going to do?
Smith would have to come up with something awful powerful.
Yeah. Ha-ha. He just flushed the toilet.
And, he made a slight adjustment, and you get a look high above.
Kiss the rim.
Throw his arm down into. He was making sure he didn't miss that one. He wants the right hand now. Up high, his hand is there.
That took his head off.
In through. Now, I think 47 is a tough score. That was a very impressive dunk. I think the judges might be affected by the fact that that's the best. 145 is his total for the three dunks.
He had his whole arm in there, Rick.
He did. He definitely had to duck his head out of the way of the rim. And that's the twist he was talking about putting on that kiss the rim. In other words, Texas has 96 coming into this, his third dunk of the semifinal round. Needs a 49 to tie Jordan.
Started in front and finished on the other side. We'll see how the judges like it, if that's enough to push him past Drexler.
I think he was just making sure that he got a good enough score to make it into the finals. He really was in a good position. Here you see him bring it up. And again, the double clutch down, back up, and over and through. And this is, again, the flair that he has. As he goes up, he's high, all the way back down on the clutch move, past the basket, and then brings it back to the two-hander over the head. Not your routine two-hand over the hand dunk shot. Only more flair. He does get a 47. He gives 143 for the semifinal round. So the two finalists will be previous champions, the defending champion
Michael Jordan with 145 points in the semifinal round, and Dominique Wilkins with 143 points in the semifinals. And this is what the crowd's been waiting for. The championship round, there'll be a coin flip to determine who goes first.
I think I'll change my pick.
It's too late. It's too late. But at least my pick is still in there. So Michael Jordan and Dominique Wilkins. This could be good. I wonder if they've saved anything for the championship round.
Well, Bob, I think that if Dominique's going to have a chance to beat Michael, he's going to have to get some kind of a running, floating type of a shot as opposed to just a strict power move.
Here's the slam dunk championship. Michael Jordan, Dominique Wilkins. And I asked you fellas if you thought Jordan should let him go first or not.
Well, I think that Jordan probably did the right thing. He's going to put the pressure on Wilkins.
And Dominique is going to give a little running start to this one. Not much, though.
From high above the rim.
Well out in front. I think that that's the key. As well as the height, how far out in front he caught it when he's able to hammer it home. And again, he makes it look like it's routine. But watch, look how far away he is. That's a great start for Dominique.
And look, still going up when he went. Right, and he stayed up for so long, took off from just inside the bottom of that circle, and was able to throw it through with authority as he tossed it up from the top of the key. We'll watch one more time. There he is from the top of the key. The perfect toss. The perfect timing, and look at he stay up, and throws it through with power.
And the perfect score of 50 on that dunk from Dominique Wilkins, now the defending champion.
Well, now Jordan does have his first taste of pressure in the slam dunk competition.
Pressure, huh? Okay. My ass.
Ready. Jordan goes up and takes it way down and then hammers it home over the top. And you'll see from way up high just how difficult it is. And we'll see the Dominique Wilkins reaction.
Motherfucker.
He looks like a heavyweight fighter who's just taken a roundhouse right. And now he's got the set to throw another one. Dominique Wilkins. So that's the second 50 of the day for Michael Jordan. But remember, the scores from previous rounds don't advance. This is the championship. Dominique Wilkins and Michael Jordan.
That has some torque.
Like 45.
Some torque.
That one exploded at the bottom of the net.
That even has the Chicago fans humming because the power that Dominique has. He has more power than any dunker that I've seen play this game.
Yeah, he does. That windmill brings water.
He almost lost it. Let's check the judges out after he hit that one. Oh, they were impressed enough to give him a 50, his second 50 in the three dunk championship competition. There is a dunk off in case there's a tie, a sudden dunk.
Well, you know what he's telling Greg Anderson? Yeah, that'll get some heat on him now. We're gonna see what the judges will do now.
What's going through his mind? He said earlier, sometimes he doesn't decide until he's in the air.
Look like a figure eight with the double clutch.
Look at him with 47.
This is much like a heavyweight championship crowd, you know, and they are trading big heavy right punches. Jordan took a long time to think about this, knowing he had to get the judges' attention.
Told you. Told your ass.
Oh, that is some great.
Big dummy.
You notice he's going with a two-hander, Steve, to get a little more power.
Looks like you're going to get robbed on this one.
Michael went in for the dunk, and he just waits to see what the score is. There's another look at that dunk. Now watch when he takes off. Look at the way he moves the ball from the right down low to the left, two hands, and throws it through with authority.
These judges are going to need the National Guard to get out of Chicago Stadium.
Yeah, the crowd now.
Well, Dominique only needs to come up with a, well, needs to come up with a great dunk here. If he gets a 49 or a 48, 49, he can't lose, or 40, 48. Michael gets a 15 and it's a dunk off.
We want Dominique Wilkins come in and again with the power and authority low with two hands.
That torture wheels on your collar, man.
That's incredible. Could we call it a make good? I mean, that's a two hand window with a,
you know what that was.
Let's watch this one again. Here he comes, takes off, two hands up, down, around, and through with two hands. Now for Michael Jordan.
That's power. And you all know how it ends.
If he could somehow do some sort of spin on the
Goodbye, y'all. Swear to God, this is going to be like NASA taking off from Chicago. Here we go, flight number 23. Small step for man. Michael Jordan dunked the ball. Oh, mankind. Stay low. We're going to do it again. Yeah, Nick, you know that you've been beat. Yeah. And that be the way it is. It is what it is, and it's over. And he got a what? Injured Evil 5. 50. Slow mo for all of the LeBron people. Kobe, that's your big brother.